ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is the third lecture of the series Love, Marriage and Divorce. This is the name, but practically we're talking about the Muslim family and the means to reform our Muslim families and to have a good start for establishing the Muslim home. Last lecture we covered the subject of al-khitbah, proposing to a woman, and we mentioned that there are certain women to whom you cannot propose. A woman who is engaged, a woman who is known to be engaged, you cannot go and propose to her. If you do so, you're violating the rights of your Muslim brother. لا يخطب الرجل على خطبة أخيه، هكذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A Muslim should not propose to a woman who is engaged by a Muslim brother until he let go or grants you a permission. And we mentioned also a woman who is divorced and she is going through her iddah. You cannot propose to her if the divorce is revocable, meaning طلاق رجعي, first طلقة, second طلقة, the first divorce, the second divorce, and the woman is spending the 3 month iddah in the house of her husband. It is haram for you to propose to this woman. It is permissible so to hint to a woman who is divorced and her divorce is irrevocable, meaning that's her third divorce and she's spending the iddah still, or a woman whose husband passed away and she's spending the iddah of a widow. You could hint, but explicit proposal is haram. And we detailed this last lecture, and we kind of mentioned also who you should propose to, ijmalan, yani summing up. And today, inshallah, we promised to detail this, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. But before I go there, there is a statement that the Arabs actually used to say, used to advise their children when they are about to seek a woman for marriage. They used to tell them, لا تتزوج من المنانة الأنانة الحنانة الشداقة الحداقة. Do not seek to marry a woman who is known to be annana. And the annana is the woman who whines a lot, for a simple reason. She overdoes it once she is sick. If she has headache, then she overdo it. She could fake sickness. Do not seek marriage from such a woman, because such one will give you a hard time. And this, by the way, applies to the men. I don't want the sister to leave with the impression we're talking about the man, because the man who initiates, some men are like this too these days. They whine because they have headache and stuff like that, and simple things, or sometimes they fake sickness. A woman should not. So this applies, by the way, to the women as well. Al-mannana, a woman who will do stuff for you and then she will remind you of what she did. When there is some trouble or something, she will say, I did this and this and this and this to you. Now the question is, how can you figure this out? The family, the mother. Look at the family. See the mother. Watch, observe the family. You will find normally this is the trait or the something that is passed on from parents to children. Number three, do not marry al-hannana, a woman who was married before and she always talks about her husband and her previous marriages to you. That is not something good, by the way. A woman who is married before, she will remind you how beautiful her life was with her previous husband. This is something that you don't want. Al-haddaqa. Al-haddaqa min al-hadaq. A woman, when she walks around, she just keeps staring at things, so she wanna buy them. She just walks around and then she looks at things around her. Basically, she wants to buy these things, regardless if this is gonna affect the budget of the family or not. And she will be willing to do whatever it takes to buy this thing, in spite of being maybe a decoration in the house or something, and driving your budget to zero or driving you broke. Ash-shaddaqah, do not marry from ash-shaddaqah min ash-shidqaini, the woman who speaks excessively all the time, all the time. This is going to be headache for you, I'm telling you. I'm talking about excessive speaking, carelessly, needlessly. She just speaks all the time. الشداقة الحداقة البراقة. البراقة is a woman who always sits in front of the mirror half of the day, making sure that her face, her body, her figure, she's just so concerned about this all the time. I'm talking about excessive now. I'm not talking about women should be negligent of their the way that they look, but overdoing it. Some women are like this. She would spend all her day in Kmart or these stores where she buys these makeup things just to make sure that she is beautiful. And the last one, do not marry a woman who is la'ima. واللؤم يا إخوة يعني being ungrateful. Ungrateful. This is a big issue. And I want to remind you that Nabiullah Ibrahim alayhi salam commanded his son Ismail actually to divorce his wife because of this. Hadith ibn Abbas fi Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari, when Nabiullah Ibrahim alayhi salam went to visit his son Ismail in Mecca and he found him out hunting, his wife did not recognize him. She did not recognize that this is the father of Ismail, Nabiullah Ibrahim. فسلم عليها وقال السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. He said السلام عليكم to her. She said وعليكم السلام. And then Sayyidina Ibrahim asked where about Ismail, where is Ismail? She said he went out to seek provision for us. Sayyidina Ismail used to be a hunter. He used to go in the desert for weeks and months sometimes to hunt, and he would bring back what he hunted to feed the family. For the wife said that خرج يقتاد لنا, يعني he went out to get us provision. Then Nabiullah Ibrahim alayhi salam asked the wife, كيف عيشكما, how is your livelihood, how things going? Look, بشر, awful, terrible, miserable. A woman like this will bring disaster to your homes.
Oh.
Right away, Nabiullah Ibrahim said to her, when your husband returns, tell him that an old man said salam to you, and he's telling you to change your doorstep. غير عتبة دارك. When Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam returned, he asked who was here. When Sayyidina Ismail returned, he asked who was here. She described him to him, and he said to her, this is my father, and he is telling me to divorce you. فها هو يعني in having a woman who is not grateful. وأذكركم يا إخوة, I want to remind you also that hadith Ibn Abbas في صحيح البخاري as well, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on the day of Eid went and delivered actually a sermon, a khutbah to the women, what did he say to them? قال يا معاشر النساء, O women, تصدقنا, give a lot of صدقة, فإني رأيت كن أكثر أهل النار. I have seen you the majority of the dwellers of the hellfire. النساء. One of the women, she ran after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in fact, and she asked him, why, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? تكفرنا العشير وتكفرنا الإحسان. You are ungrateful to your husbands. لو أحسن إليكن الرجل الدهر كله ثم رأيتن منه شيئا تكرهنا لقلتن ما رأينا منك خيرا قط. هذه قط دي اللي توجع. قط دي اللي تجنن يعني. يعني the man is going by the book. The first bad thing that you see from him, you will say what? I haven't seen a good day at all with you. At all with you. يعني تحضرني هذه القصة, خليفة من بني العباس, one of the leaders of بني العباس, أمير المؤمنين. He married يعني a prestigious woman from a high-fi family. يعني so she was walking on the road, and she saw the farmers, you know, stepping on the mud. They are going on the mud with their feet. Sometimes farmers do this to make the land, the earth, soft for the seed. But she liked that. She wished she can do this. But she went back home and she said to her husband, Al-Amir, يعني I saw these people going with their feet in the mud, and I really want to do this. طبعا ما ينفعش يعني the wife of Amir al-Mu'minin goes out there in the crowd and does this. He said, don't worry about it. He collected for her straw and some mud, and he actually mixed it with musk. So he made for her some sort of a farm at home, small farm at home. يعني. So she doesn't go outside, and she exposes her feet and so forth. So she went and يعني, she enjoyed herself with the stepping on the mud and in the tin. يعني. Later on, he upset her. She said to him, I have not even seen one good day with you. نفس الكلام اهو. سو الامير يقول لها ولا يوم الطين. Not even the muddy day. What happened to the muddy day? You don't even remember the mud. You remember the mud and the musk. هكذا. Having a woman who is not grateful is a disaster, because she will never be happy with what you provide. These are just some of the characteristics. Without delay, inshallah, let's go into who should you seek for wives? Who should you propose to? The first and foremost, ya ikhwa, ad-deen, the religion. يعني نصوص قاتلة. تنكح المرأة لأربع. This is one. A woman is asked in marriage because of four things. her physical beauty, her money, she has a good paying job, her lineage. And in America, we could say with her lineage, her green card. Because she's American, she's going to give you a green card. Right? And her religion. فورا. فاظفر بذات الدين تربت يداك. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say marry. He said what? When, as if you have to fight for this one. You're not going to find them just out there in the walks. You have to look for them. Righteous women are not everywhere. Righteous women are hidden. You have to find them. فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَاكَ. You better go with the one, for the one with the religion, otherwise you're going to be in trouble. الحديث الآخر, the second hadith, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما, والحديث في صحيح مسلم, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, الدنيا متاع. This world is a temporary enjoyment. وخير متاعها, and the best of its enjoyment, المرأة الصالحة, a righteous wife. Why يا رسول الله, why O Messenger of Allah, wording of الإمام النسائي, إذا نظرت إليها أسرتك. If you look at her, she will please you. I want to stress here that it's just not meant the physical beauty here. I stress الخلق, المرأة الخلوقة, a woman with good character. Sometimes you see a Barbie, so beautiful physical wise, but her manners turns you off, her character. Yani imagine a beautiful woman and she uses profanity, for example. Man, what is that? S, that S word, huh? SH, stuff like that. That turns you off. Even so, what? فيعني إذا نظرت إليها, when you look at her, you don't really have to understand this. Yeah, physical is. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث, حديث ابن مسعود أخرجه ابن سعد في الطبقات, دعاء المرآة, the supplication. What is the supplication which you should say when you look at the mirror? What? Huh? اللهم كما أحسنت خلقي أحسن خلقي. هكذا كان يفعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Oh Allah, so when you look at the mirror and you admire yourself, you admire your face, say, Oh Allah, like you have made my face beautiful and handsome, attractive, make my manners also what? Handsome and attractive. Because this is what will make people like you. I want to stress what is meant here. If you look at her, she will please you. It does not just mean the physical beauty. It means actually the good character. إذا نظرت إليها أسرتك وإذا غبت عنها حفظتك في نفسها ومالك. And when you leave her at home by herself, you're sure that she's going to guard herself, her chastity. She's not going to allow somebody in your absence into your house. She's not going to go around men. You will never even have that thought about her. And it's a big problem if you develop doubt about your wife and her behavior in your absence. Shaitan is going to play games, football and soccer and basketball and baseball with you. If you actually develop that thought, that's actually a key. That when you leave the house, you know your wife is chaste. She's not going to have a relationship in the side. And when you command her, she will obey you. Or when you take an oath on her, she will not basically cause you to commit al-hanath, that you have to obey or fast for breaking that oath. Before I carry on talking about this, I want the sisters, because I know sisters will be listening to this, watching this, or maybe they are here tonight with us. I really do want to say that the issue here is not just being slaves to the husbands. No. Actually, the sisters can do this out of selfishness. And listen to this hadith, and look, I will make you, I'll help you understand what I'm trying to say here. Hadith fi Sahih ibn Hibban. Hadith Abu Hurairah. And with Imam Ahmad, Hadith Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. Look, إِذَا صَلَّتِ الْمَرْأَةُ خَمْسَهَا. If the woman prays her 5 daily prayers, وَصَامَتْ شَهْرَهَا, and she fasts the month of Ramadan, وَحَفِظَتْ فَرْجَهَا, and she kept herself chaste, وَأَطَاعَتْ زَوْجَهَا, and she obeyed her husband, قيل لها يوم القيامة ادخلي من أبواب الجنة أيما شئت. يا الله, it will be said to her in the day of resurrection, there are 8 gates from Jannah, choose one of them. Oh, so I want to say to the sisters, if your agenda is the hereafter, your husband can be the way. Yani, we know the only man in this ummah so far who will get to choose which gate of the Jannah will he enter from is who? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Every single Muslim woman, if she fulfills these requirements in the day of resurrection, also she will choose which gate of Jannah she would like to enter from. We know Jannah had 8 gates, Rayyan, Salah, Sadaqah, Al-Mar'a Takhtar. The woman will choose because of this. We're talking about the women obeying their husbands and so forth. We're not trying to enslave the women here, okay? We're talking about the hereafter, and we're talking about sisters who would like to go to Jannah. Sisters who want to get to Jannah. I want to tell you, my sisters in Islam, your husbands is the way to go. But again, I want to stress, الطاعة here, the obedience here, does not mean that you command her more than what she can bear. يعني ما تقولش you have to obey me, and then you command her to jump to the moon. إذا أردت أن تطاع فأمر بالمستطاع. If you want to be obeyed, then command the person whom you're wanting him to do what they can bear. But don't command them to do weird stuff, haram stuff also. لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. If the husband commands the sisters, the wives, to do something that is haram, the sister does not have to obey him, for example. عندنا حديث آخر يا إخوة, حديث يعني حقيقة أنا أحب هذا الحديث جدا, والحديث في شعب الإيمان. حديث أبو أمامة الباهلي رضي الله عنه. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم one day he said to معاذ بن جبل, يا معاذ, قلب شاكر, a grateful heart, ولسان ذاكر, أنا a tongue that remembers Allah all the time. In the morning, you wake up, alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا. You go to the bathroom, أعوذ بالله, أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. Before you make wudu, bismillah. After you make wudu, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم اجعلني من التوابين واجعلني من المتطهرين. You do أذكار الصباح. Before you get off the house, bismillah, وتوكلنا على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You get in the car, سبحان الذي سخرنا. لسان شاكر, ذاكر, always, a tongue that remembers Allah all the time. Here it is. وامرأة صالحة. امرأة صالحة. And a righteous woman تعينك على أمر دنياك ودينك. Who will help you with your dunya matters, with your dunya business and your deen, your religion. When you slack in the morning, you don't wake up for Fajr, wake up for Fajr. She will wake you up. When you don't pray on time, why don't you pray? She will remind you of your the acts of worship which you have to pray, you have to observe. خير ما اكتنز الناس من الدنيا is the best thing that a person can get from the dunya. حديث آخر also في مستدرك الحاكم, حديث سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ثلاثة من السعادة Three things are marks or signs of happiness. Three things which can indicate that you're happy. المرأة تراها تعجبك. A wife you look at, you like to look at her. وتغيب عنها فتأمنها على نفسها ومالك. And when you leave the house, you trust her regarding herself and your wealth. والدابة, and having a good car, good animal, يعني تكون يعني سهلة. يعني when you have a car that breaks all the time, that's not a sign of happiness. You have to take it to the mechanic all the time. It's not a sign of happiness. والدار الواسعة, and you have a house that has bathrooms, has a place where you can sit, has a place where you can pray. يعني it doesn't have to be يعني huge, but the house has what good facilities. يعني نذكر قصة يا إخوة في هذا السياق, just to let you know. القصة معروفة, يعني you probably heard it so many times, but we remind you. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, when he used to be Amir al-Mu'mineen, one day he, يعني هذا هو عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he used to say, if an animal, if a cow in Iraq does not have a road to walk on, Umar will be asked about this cow in the day of resurrection. He used to spend his night going around the streets, making sure that the people are fed, making sure that everybody is okay. So he got tired. So he sat next to a wall in the morning, and he heard that conversation between a mother and her daughter. The mother is telling her daughter, mix the milk with water. You know, when you sell milk and you add water to it, you're going to end up with more milk. The daughter tells her mother, Ya Ummah, mother, Amir al-Mu'mineen naha an dhalik. The commander of the faithful banned us from doing this. Oh. Look what the mother tells her daughter. But Amir al-Mu'mineen is not with us. He's not here now. Sayyidina Umar is listening, actually. She doesn't know that. Amir al-Mu'mineen doesn't hear us. Look what the daughter said. But the Lord of Amir al-Mu'mineen is with us. ولكن رب عمر معنا. Imagine Umar ibn al-Khattab. Remember, a woman is asked in marriage because of four things. فاظفر, win, the one with the religion. Umar runs home, ran home, wakes up his three children, Abdullah, Abdurrahman, and Asim. One of you has to marry this woman, otherwise I'm marrying her. شايف فاظفر. He did not even, did he see her? Did he see her face? He did not. He did not. But what he worried about, she has the consciousness of Allah. The Lord of Umar will see us when we mix the milk with water. Sayyidina Umar, ya ikhwah, he used to say this. He's looking at the offspring here. He used to say, Wallahi, by Allah, I force myself to have intercourse with my spouse, with my wife, in order to have children who say, La ilaha illallah. Oh. How many of us, when we go and have that relationship, we want to have those children who come out and say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. We don't even think about that. Oh. فعمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he wants offspring from this woman, from this little girl or the girl he heard her speaking with her mother. عاصم, his son, said, أنا أتزوجها يا أمير المؤمنين. He said, I will marry her, commander of the faithful. So عاصم married her. Look at this now. She had a daughter whose name is Layla. Layla is the grandmother of who? Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. يعني a lot of scholars consider him a fifth rightly guided Amir al-Mu'mineen. enough that he compiled the Sunnah, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. He was the reason. نادى على ابن شهاب الزهري قال لا اجمع السنة collect compile the Sunnah enough. في زمانه العدل انتشر. Why? Because of a righteous mother like this. طيب, we're talking about the man here. What about the women? The same exact thing. Rather, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم addressing the guardians. إذا جاءكم من ترضون دينه وخلقه فزوجوه إلا تفعلوا تكن فتنة في الأرض وفساد عريض. Oh. If someone comes to you, you're pleased with what? Two things. So you have to check what? Two things. What? Deen and manners. Character. It tells you also, ya ikhwa, that there is a relationship between the two. في علاقة, there is a relationship between the religion and the manner. تلاقي أحيانا, sometimes you find a brother who 24/7 in the masjid. بس لا يتورع. He does not even think before backbiting, gossiping or being mean. أهو, خلق. بالعكس, the contrary to this. If you have religion, that religion should produce a good character out of you. ولذلك, يعني our righteous predecessors, they used to say this, من زاد عنك في الخلق فقد زاد عنك في الدين. If you want to compare the quality of the religion of someone with the quality of your religion, if he is better than you character wise, then rest assured that هو دين. He is more religious than you. He has more consciousness of Allah than you. So the issue is manner here. The issue is manner. So you have to check the manner of this person and you have to check his religion as well. And why, the question here, why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam address the guardians? Huh? Why? لأن المرأة لا تنكح نفسها. A woman. You see, once it comes to the sisters getting married, it's a mutual decision between the father and the girl or the woman. A woman cannot give herself in marriage without the agreement, without the permission of her father. Period. والحديث واضح. حديث رواه أحمد وأبو داود والترمذي. Listen to this. أيما امرأة نكحت نفسها من بغير إذن وليها فنكاحها باطل فنكاحها باطل فنكاحها باطل. Any woman who gives herself in marriage, and I say this to the brothers who find the sister, let's go to the imam, and the imam doesn't know the sharia, oh, marry, 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 without the father even knowing. Without the father even knowing. Yani, sometimes brothers, they come to me like this, and the father, for example, is overseas. And then I tell him, listen, I have to talk to this father. If you want to get married today, I have to talk to him. He gets upset. I tell him, ya akhi, how would you like your daughter to get married without her father's knowing? If you have a daughter, how would you feel about your daughter getting married behind your back? تيجي ببنتك كده تقول لك يا ابا انا اتزوجت. Your daughter comes to you, tells you, father, I got married. يا سلام, got married? Huh? How do you feel about this? A woman cannot give herself in marriage. I tell the brothers, one of the conditions for the marriage contract to be valid, الولي, and the permission of the guardian. والولي هو الأب, then الأخ, then العم, the father. If the father is dead or he left Islam, then الأخ, then the brother, the elder brother first, then العم, then the uncle, then any of her maharim. But now the decision also, this does not mean that in Islam the father dictates who the girl should get married. لا, لا تستنكح الأيم حتى تستأمر أو تستأمر تستأمر. A woman who is a widow or been married before, she does not get married until she says, yes, I would like to get married to this person. طيب, ولا تنكح البكر حتى تستأذن. And the virgin cannot get married without her permission. Her permission. الصحابي الحديث متفق عليه, ده حديث ده تو صحيح, حديث ابن عباس الصحابي يا إخوة, the companion said to the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, a virgin girl, a girl who's never been married before, normally if you go to her as a father, would you like to marry this person? She shies away. She shy, يعني بتستحي البنت. She shy. إذنها سكوتها. بيقول لك اللي إيه السكوت علامة الإيه؟ الرضا. كلام جاي كله بالسنة. Silence is a sign of what? Of acceptance. I'm not trying to say that the father is going to dictate who the girl should get married to, because we have an issue too that fathers now or parents now, when somebody righteous, somebody comes with a ما شاء الله من أهل السنة وجاي عشان يتجوز البنت, إيه ده يا أخت الإرهاب اللي جاي يتجوز بنتي ده, this terrorist coming to marry my daughter, ودم دروش ومش عارف مالهمش, يعني يأتي رجل دين عنده دين بيصلي الخمس فروض, لا ده متعصب, لا احنا عايزين واحد كده مودرن شوي, لا or he's not wealthy, he's نعم he has the religion but he's not wealthy, يعني it's a mutual decision once it comes to the sisters. And by the way, the marriage contract, I want to stress, the marriage contract is invalid if the father forces the daughter to get married to somebody without her will, without her acceptance. The daughter must agree, and this is the responsibility of those who get these girls, get the women married, as an imam, as a ma'zoon, as rajul, as a person of sharia, you must ask her, before I get anybody married, I ask the women, okay, this is your wali, he's your wali, right? He's gonna speak on your behalf, right? He's gonna say yes to the husband, you're okay with that? If she tells me no, I'm not gonna get her married, period, because it's invalid. الحديث واضح, لا تستنكح الأيم حتى تستأمر ولا تنكح البكر حتى تستأذن. And the virgin cannot be basically given in marriage until she gives a permission. But the shahid is, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in this hadith addressed the guardian, because he is the one at the end of the day who has to basically seek that husband or accept this husband. وعندنا في السنة يا إخوة يعني أحاديث, ويعني يكفينا القصة بتاعة الرجل الصالح في مدين, when he went to موسى عليه السلام, أهو he went to موسى, قال له إني أريد أن أنكحك, يعني I just want to let you know that how important it is that you choose a righteous husband for your daughters, to the extent that you come up with something that is not normal. إن الرجل يذهب لرجل آخر, that you go to another man and you tell him, would you like to marry my daughter? شوف, to achieve this, this is not normal, this is not something normal. لأن يعني الواحد لما يعرض ابنته, when you offer your daughter to people especially if you're offering it to somebody who is يعني سفيه ولا شيء, ممكن يقول ده بنت دي بايرة, يعني his daughter is not يعني good or something, there is something wrong with her. But I want to tell you that if you find a man who is righteous and pious, oh, هذا الرجل الصالح, this righteous man said to موسى عليه السلام, إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى ابنتي هاتين على أن تأجرني ثمانية حجج. وعندنا سبحان الله سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب لما تأيمت حفصة من خنيس بن حذافة السهمي, والحديث في البخاري من حديث ابن عمر, سيدنا عمر went to عثمان ابن عفان, يا عثمان would you like to marry حفصة, أهو. And then later on عثمان said لا حاجة لي. Then he said to أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه, would you like to marry حفصة؟ سيدنا أبو بكر did not answer him. فسيدنا عمر got a little bit upset. But at the end, سيدنا أبو بكر رضي الله عنه explained to him that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned حفصة in front of him. ذكر حفصة. يعني he showed some interest in front of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq that he would like to marry Hafsa. فسيدنا أبو بكر did not want to reveal the secret of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and at the same time did not want to tell عمر no. فat the end الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم تزوجها. وعندنا إخوة قصة عجيبة, يعني قصة جليبيب هذه, يعني just to let you know that whenever a sister goes for a righteous man she is always a winner. جليبيب يعني صحابي, a companion who did not have that physical يعني attraction. He was not attractive physically. He was not handsome يعني. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم noticed that he hangs around him. كان من أهل الصفة يعني. He was around the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم noticed that he's looking at, يعني he would look at the women. He's a young man. And then الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, would you like to get married? Would you like, I can tell that you're interested in women. Would you like to get married? He said, sure, but why you, يعني, who's going to give me his daughter? Who's going to marry me? He understands that he's not attractive. He's not يعني handsome. He's not good looking. فمن عادة الأنصار, the custom of الأنصار, when someone has a daughter for marriage, the father would come to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقول يا رسول الله أو messenger of Allah, I have a daughter for marriage. If you have a husband, I would يعني like to you to find a husband for her. فسبحان الله, one of the Ansar came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال I have a husband for your daughter. Immediately the father got so excited because he thought that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would marry her. فقال من, he said he's not known, it's not me. قال من, قال جليبيب. جليبيب, he actually did like this. جليبيب, يعني the man was يعني smart. He said let me talk with his with her mother, يعني I have to consult with her mother. See, she went, he went home. The daughter was standing behind a curtain and listening to the conversation between the father and the mother. The father is telling the mother that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a husband for our daughter. She said, ni'ma ayni, what a good thing. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose this. Oh. قالت من, she said who, قال جليبيب. قالت ها هن ها, جليبيب, no way, impossible, impossible. سبحان الله يا إخوة, look, and I'm addressing the sisters, I'm talking to the sisters. The girl came from behind the curtain. قالت والله ما أرد من ارتضاه لي رسول الله, I will marry جليبيب. By Allah, I will not reject the one whom the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم chose for me. يحكي هذا الخبر أنس ابن مالك رضي الله عنه. شوف, she get married to him. Maybe a week later, time to go out for jihad. سبحان الله, at the end of the battle, the companions are looking for the deceased of the Muslims everywhere. And then the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم is asking the companions, did you find every Muslim who is being killed in this battle? They said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. قال ولكني أفقد جليبيبا, but I do not see جليبيب. He went and he found him killed next to 7 disbelievers. قال قتلهم ثم قتلوه. He killed them, then they killed him. He raised him in his hand like this, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he buried him with his hand. And he said, ذاك جليبيب, this is جليبيب. هو مني وأنا من. هو مني وأنا من. هو مني وأنا من. He's from me and I'm from him. ودعا له. And he made dua for him and he buried him. شوف يا إخوة, هذه المرأة, this woman, this girl, يحكي أنس, أنس swears, by Allah, The rich, the wealthiest of Medina were standing in line trying to get married to her after she spent the iddah. Why? Because they knew that she obeyed the Messenger of Allah. فالخطاب, she was looking for a husband, just a husband. Now, the wealthiest of the people in Medina are standing in line waiting to marry her when she is a widow, not a virgin. Why? Because of the obedience to her husband, the obedience to Allah and His Messenger. She went for what Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, chosen for her. يعني أنا أعلم, I know that أنا يعني سبحان الله, والله something breaks the heart. والله breaks the heart. إنك تسمع that you hear a Muslim woman marrying a non-Muslim. Of course, it's not called marriage. The contract is not a marriage contract. This is called adultery. أهو الأذانة. This is called adultery. فأسوق لهم يعني قصة أم سليم. By the way, أم سليم was giving glad tidings of Jannah. يعني ورد في حديث أنس والنسائي, أنس في مسند أحمد وسنن النسائي السنن الكبرى وصحيح ابن حبان, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, دخلت الجنة فسمعت خشفة فقلت من هذا, فقال الرميصاء بنت ملحان. I entered Jannah and I heard some noise and I said, who is this? They said, الرميصاء بنت ملحان, اللي هي أم سليم. أم سليم هذه لها قصة عجيبة يا إخوة. She is the mother of Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه. She became a Muslim when Mus'ab ibn Umair came to Medina and started talking to the people in Medina about Islam. Her husband Malik did not like this. So he became upset and he left town that she became a Muslim, and she would talk to Anas about Islam. She would actually, when she يعني breastfeeding Anas, she would say, Ya Anas, say La ilaha illallah Ya Anas, as if she's preparing Anas يعني for the mission. فهر husband heard her saying this, اللي هو مالك, the father of Anas, and he said to her, you're spoiling my son for me. And he went away. Subhanallah, he got killed. مات على الكفر. فshe became أيم, she's a widow. The best, the wealthiest of people in Medina came to her. His name is Abu Talha al-Ansari, who was not a Muslim yet, asking her in marriage. Huh? Listen what she said. والله, by Allah, يا أبا طلحة. By Allah, يا أبا طلحة. And this goes to the women, to the Muslim women who gave up their deen because she falls in love with a non-Muslim, or because the non-Muslim is wealthy, he's going to give her the dunya, or he's going to give her a green card too, whatever it is. We find Muslim women now marrying non-Muslims. Umm Sulaym right here, a role model for the Muslim women until the day of resurrection. Wallahi ya Aba Talha, by Allah ya Aba Talha, mithluk la yurad. Someone like you, no woman who is sane will say no to him. Walakinaka rajulun kafir, but you are a disbeliever. Wa ana imra'atun muslima, and I'm a Muslim woman. ولا يحل لي أن أتزوج منك, and it is not halal for me to marry from you. فإنك إن تسلم, if you become a Muslim, فذاك مهري, this is my dowry. لا أسألك غيره, I will not ask you anything else. You become a Muslim, I marry you. أهو. He came a couple of times, he poured, one of the wording, he poured gold and silver in front of her. The same thing. مثلك, someone like you, no way that a woman can say no to. إنك رجل كافر, you're a disbeliever, and I'm a Muslimah. And I am not to marry a rajul kafir. Aslim, become a Muslim, this is my dowry. Sayyidina Abu Talha al-Ansari radiyallahu an accepted Islam. قالت يا أنس قم فزوجني. Anas was little. When he said أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله, she said يا أنس stand up and give me in marriage to Abu Talha. يعني some of the people may say يعني she was the reason. She was the reason for that marriage. Yes, but في حديث, just to show you that subhanallah, sometimes a person would become a Muslim because of this, but his Islam becomes a quality Islam. Becomes a quality Islam. يعني لما نزلت هذه الآية, when this verse was revealed in Surah Al Imran, لن تنالوا البر حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. Huh? You know the hadith? You will never attain Jannah until you spend from that which you love most. Huh? What did Abu Talha say? Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, Inna ahabba mali ilay bi'r bayruha. The most beloved of my wealth is the will of bayruha. Ya Rasul Allah, I want to give it for Allah. Oh, he came out of his wealth. Just to show you that his Islam, yes, was triggered by this righteous woman, but yet he ended up with a quality Islam. I want to conclude by saying, we as guardians, we as men, we must seek righteousness in our spouses. We must. Otherwise, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَاغْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكْ. Inshallah, we stop here, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى tonight. We continue next week, inshallah, with the rest of the attributes which you should seek in a husband as a guardian of a woman, or you should seek in a woman if you are a male who is seeking marriage. And after that, inshallah, we go into the conditions for the marriage contract and how the marriage contract should be put together. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.